All right, everybody. Well, it's time to get hyped because it's your boy, WWE Superstar Mojo Rawley, coming at you. And welcome to Mojo's Moments, where we hype up our heroes. And today, kicking us off, we got a guy that's kind of hyped. I'll let you guys decide. But welcome to JJ Montoya, who is a teacher at the Valencia Newcomer School in Phoenix, Arizona. JJ, how we feeling, baby?
Yeah, baby. I am hype, Mojo. We're ready to do this. Thank you.
Oh, man, I'm going to have to try and keep up with you today. Usually it's the other way around, energy wise. Yeah. But now, so Valencia Newcomer School, you guys are one of the first schools that WWE visited when we launched our partnership with UNICEF Kid Power, and you guys are one of the most active schools in the world for the UNICEF Kid Power program. So wanted to chat with you a little bit about that and how, you know, life this year has been affected by everything going on in the world, and, you know, just chat about your partnership with UNICEF a little bit today.
Beautiful.
So just first question for you, my friend, what inspired you to become an educator and to work specifically with refugee and migrant students?
Sure. I wanted to do something that served my community here in Phoenix, Arizona. I was looking around. There's lots of great ways to be serving a community. Actually, I was thinking about becoming a garbage truck driver. Because shout out to them. They keep our community clean. Took a trip to Washington, D.C., and that city just is so inspiring to me. Saw what President Kennedy said, ask not what your country can do for you. What can you do for your country? I took that as, what could I do for my community? What could I do for Phoenix, Arizona? And something I said, I'm going to try teaching. Teaching is giving back. Teachers are part of their community and a big part. And I came home and jumped back into college and set that goal. And that's what inspired me to want to be a teacher.
That's awesome to hear. You know, I think teachers and everyone in the school system are some of our most underrated heroes out there. And, you know, my mom's been in the school system since the late 90s. So I've heard all of her stories, which is why I wanted to chat with you guys, with you so much today about just everything going on. Because, you know, that kind of segues me into the next point. How is, you know, the current time frame really shaped and changed your classes, you know, maybe making things more difficult or even some happy surprises that you you found along the way?
Some of the difficulties, it was very scary at first. Just everything just shut down. And we went on spring break and then didn't come back and no communication with the students. So some of them didn't have internet. So it was a struggle to connect with them and just say, and at the beginning, it was just, how are you? How are things going? And now that we've come back to school, got them all hooked up to the internet, and we're doing this virtual learning, it's different, but it's still we're able to see each other. We're able to make a different connection. I'm always high-fiving, fist bumping, hugging. We can't do that, but we can see each other's faces. We can hear our voices, and there's hope on the way. I've been worried about them. They've been worried about me. And what's nice is every day they're asking me, how are you? They ask about my family. We ask about their families. And we're all on the same page. We're connected and really we are a family that's connected, and we're looking out for each other. So that's the fun thing about this time. I think they're always going to remember this year, and I hope that they remember me, and I hope that I'm a part of helping them get through this, because they're definitely helping me get through this difficult time.
That's amazing. And I can tell you right now that, you know, I'm 34 now. I still remember all my teachers when I was a little kid that kind of helped me through and pulled me out when I was getting into trouble and, you know, kind of scolded me into shape. So I think the impact that you're making right now is going to go so much farther than you think. And to see that it's kind of coming full circle, where they're actually lifting you up as you lift them up, I mean, that's got to be what it's all about, right?
Absolutely. Yeah.
So tell me a little bit about UNICEF Kid Power. So I was hearing all about this program, and it's really cool. But for those that are listening that might not be as familiar with it, why don't you tell us a little bit about that and you know, how you've interfaced that with just your own classroom?
Sure. I found out about it through WWE. I've been a WWE, part of the WWE universe for my whole life. I'm 47 years old and can just it was part of my childhood, and it's still part of my life, and just brings a lot of joy. And then I saw how this works. This is something that WWE has partnered with for with educators, and you know that got my. And then I started looking at this. This is great. I like how it offers a chance for students to get involved and get involved in their local community and their global community and help out. And I just started doing some of the power-ups with the kids, and they responded. They love that, even though they've been through some tough times, they've had struggles, but they still can help others, and they want to help others, and they want to give back. They want to be a part of their local community and their global community, and UNICEF Kid Powers helps them to achieve that goal.
And so these Kid Power videos, so they work by, you know, they're maybe like, what, 5-minute videos that you can watch with your whole class that, you know, teaches them about nutrition or life skills or even get some exercise.
Absolutely.
Or I heard even doing some dancing is some of them, huh?
Yep. We get up, we get dancing. I make a fool of myself and they love it. I can't dance as cool as they do, but it's who cares? You know, we're having fun.
That's right.
You know, we're bringing the hype. And at the end, it gives us some points. It tells us how many coins we've earned, how many ready-to-use therapeutic packets of food we're giving. And they love to see that tracking number. They love to see how many people they've helped. And it's just an awesome thing. And I love it that my students love to help others. They see, yeah, we may need help at times, but there are times when we can help others. And like I said, gets us up, gets us moving, and gets them motivated to learn. Well,
that's incredible. That tracking number has got to be one of the best parts, because you're literally watching as you're feeding kids all over
it's the
world.
Scoreboard, yeah, and they could see the scoreboard. They love to see what place our class is in, and the most important thing, just knowing how many people they've helped around the world, just makes them feel good.
Man, that's absolutely incredible.
Yeah.
Well, I gotta say, I mean, dancing is one of my few gifts in this world. I mean, I might not have like the coolest dance moves, but if you want to talk about making a fool out of yourself, I'm definitely the guy for that in the dance department. So if you ever need a tag partner when you're getting tired on these dance videos, tag your boy in.
You have this link. You're welcome. You can jump in anytime. Yeah. You know, we've seen a lot of, they enjoy a lot of the WWE superstars have made some power-ups like, Bailey, Tyler Breeze, Mustafa, Andrade, and we'd love to see you make one of those power-up videos and have a Mojo one that we could hype to.
It's already in the works, baby. We're already working on
something. Yeah, can't wait to see that one.
All right, so now I definitely didn't tip you off on what's coming next, so don't get nervous.
Okay.
But, you know, Mojo Rawley, I'm the hype man. I like
yes,
to
you
hype
are.
People up. That's my thing. So now you have your students, but for everyone else out there listening, whether it's students in other schools, their parents, teachers, anything, I'm going to put you on the spot right now and make you do an authentic Mojo Rawley hype promo to hype up everybody to stay on it during these tough times and stay educated and keep plugging away in the classroom. So if you want to go ahead and use a crazy voice or just talk normal, give us a few cents here to hype up the masses real quick.
Teachers, students, it's out there. UNICEF Power Up. Get on. Get active. Get involved. Save lives, baby. You can do it. We can do it. We're teachers. We're students. We got the power. Use the power and save some lives, baby. Yeah.
That was fantastic. That hyped me up.
Oh, man. Yeah, that felt good. I always wanted to do one of those.
You're a natural, man. I better watch that.
I've been watching for years. Felt like Mean Gene was next to me.
Oh, man. Well, I love it. And JJ, thank you so much for your time today.
Thank you, Mojo.
Awesome. But for anyone looking to support, you know, their kids and making a difference, check out UNICEF Kid Power. And join the road to WrestleMania 37 sweepstakes at unicefusa.org/WM37 because WWE is giving away 4 chances to win $2,000 to improve your school or community. So check it out. Again, the new hype master, JJ Montoya. of Valencia Newcomer School in Phoenix, Arizona. Thank you
so much
for everything that you do, baby.
Thank you, Mojo.